Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2286, a first lookup at XLOOKUP. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, August 28th, 2019 at noon, Microsoft is releasing a new function to Office Insiders. You have to be on Office 365 and you have to opt into Office Insiders fast, and you have to be in the lucky, 10, 25% who are in the first flight. New function that is designed to be a VLOOKUP killer, is XLOOKUP. Here are the advantages of XLOOKUP over VLOOKUP. XLOOKUP can find the last match in a list. XLOOKUP can look to the left. And unlike VLOOKUP, which requires you to have to say comma false at the end, the fourth argument, XLOOKUP automatically defaults to an exact match. By default, it doesn't support wildcards, but you can allow them if you want them to happen. It has all of the speed improvements released to VLOOKUP back in 2018. And by the way, if you're on Insider Fast, you don't have those VLOOKUP speed improvements, so this is the only way to get the speed improvements for those of you on Insider Fast. Probably the most important one, and this is really subtle, VLOOKUP, that third argument, relies on an integer column number. You want the third column. And then if someone inserts a column in the middle of your lookup table, all the VLOOKUPs break. XLOOKUP won't have that problem. Also, because you're only referring to two columns instead of the whole lookup table, you're going to have a performance improvement. And this one's very subtle. VLOOKUP always returned a value, but XLOOKUP actually returns a range, which means that you can ask for the row of XLOOKUP, which might be useful in data validation. What are the disadvantages? Why are the reasons you'd still want to use XLOOKUP? Well, because none of your uncool friends, the people who aren't on Insiders, don't have it. And even your cool friends, the people who are on Insiders, a really large percentage of those today still don't have it. So until it rolls out widely, right now it's just something super cool for us to look at. So here is the signature. All right, XLOOKUP, lookup value. What are we looking up? Just like VLOOKUP. But then instead of specifying the whole table, you specify the column where the lookup values might be found, comma, the column where the results are going to be found. And this, theoretically, because of dynamic arrays, could be multiple columns if you want to return two columns. Most of the time, it'll be a single column. All right, and then those are the only required arguments. If you don't say anything else, the match mode is going to default to exact, which is great. That's what I do 99% of the time. But if you're one of the people that wanted to do the range lookup, you can use minus one for exact or next smaller, or one for exact or next larger, or if you really want to do a wildcard lookup, you can put a two in there. And then search mode, again, if you don't do anything, the default is first to last, just like VLOOKUP always did, but minus one, last to first, we'll find the last matching value, or they still offer the binary search options. However, Joe McDade, who's the architect of this feature on the Excel team, says, look, he's never going to use this because there's a chance that someone's going to sort the lookup table and then you start to get wrong results. All right, so here we go. Here's a little lookup table, SKU, category, and description. With standard VLOOKUP, this is a VLOOKUP of A2 into that whole table. Press F4. We want the third column, comma zero or comma false for an exact match. If you leave that off, it defaults to the binary, the approximate match, and just chaos ensues. To do the same thing with XLOOKUP of A2, next up is the lookup vector, which is going to be these cells right here. Yes, I'm going to press F4, and then the results are going to be the description over here, press F4, and that's it. No comma false required, and we'll get the answer. And to show you an example of where this is an advantage over VLOOKUP, let's say that someone inserts a new column here in the lookup table. VLOOKUP will break because it's still looking for column 3, but XLOOKUP, because it's explicitly pointing to a results vector, that results vector is going to move over when someone inserts the column. This is a really unusual use of XLOOKUP, but if in the results argument I would point to both G and H, thanks to dynamic arrays, I will get two results, like a category here and description here. All right, this is a beautiful, great advantage of XLOOKUP. All right, so here we have a fleet of vehicles. Every time the vehicle comes in for service, the date, and they note the mileage. I had a person in England, on a farm in England, a horse farm in England, asked me this question. They said, hey, we want to know the latest mileage reading that we know for each of these. So they wanted to do a search from the bottom. I'll have to find that podcast. It was horrendous what we had to do. But now with XLOOKUP just out here, we want the exact match for the vehicle, and then search from the bottom, and it'll find the last value in the list. A nice improvement there. VLOOKUP can't go left. Well, XLOOKUP, because we get to specify the search vector and the results vector, then no problem having that go to the left. How about the case where you have to do 12 columns of VLOOKUP or XLOOKUP? Oh, that was so horrible. You had to edit the comma 2 to be comma 3 to comma 4, comma 5. It's just going to be this equal XLOOKUP of this value back here in column A, and we'll press F4 1, 2, 3 times to lock down the column. And then the search vector is going to be that set of cells, F4, comma, and then to point to January results, we'll press F4. We'll press F4 not once, but twice to lock it down to rows 4 to 227, but the queue is allowed to move to the right as we copy it across. No, what the heck am I thinking? That's old-fashioned. Look, XLOOKUP can return a whole array of values. Just specify the whole columns there, and we'll get 12 results thanks to dynamic arrays. This will be much easier. All right, now what about the weird versions where we had to do a range lookup? So, VLOOKUP, where it had to go find the nearest value that was just less than. So here we have a bonus table, and this always had to be sorted in the past, no longer has to be sorted. The match type is now going to be -1 for exact or next smaller. And what about the case where we need to find the next largest value? XLOOKUP can handle that as well. So here in this case, we're looking for a vehicle that will hold 9 passengers. We need to find the value that's just greater than that. That'll be the white van that holds 14 passengers, not the van that holds 7 passengers. And normally, with VLOOKUP, this would have to be sorted. XLOOKUP, no requirement for that at all. The one right there says we're looking for the value just larger. And because I'm specifying a 2-column results table, I'll get both the recommended vehicle and the cost. All right, this XLOOKUP is pretty exciting. You know, I'm a huge fan of VLOOKUP, and I know there's index and match people out there. XLOOKUP is designed to bring those two groups together. Both of us can start to use XLOOKUP instead of VLOOKUP or index and match as soon as it rolls out to the rest of the insiders, and then the monthly channel, and then to all the Office 365 people, and then we get all of our friends on Excel 2016 or 2019 to change to a subscription model. Then it'll be beautiful. Just all of those tiny things have to happen. Now, of course, I'll be talking about this at all of my seminars, and there's only 5 left. Excelapalooza, September 16th through the 18th. Oz and Tom Erz will be there as well. Springfield, Missouri on the 19th. Chicago on October 1st. Appleton, Wisconsin on the 16th. And the last one, taking a ride on the Chattanooga Choo Choo on November 12th. Check out my website if you want to catch me at one of my last seminars. I'm retiring from traveling around to do seminars. I'll still do them here locally in Florida, but this is your last chance now. Oh, Joe McDade, you killed me. My new book, Mr. Excel LX, the Holy Grail of Excel Tips, now officially today at noon, obsolete because it doesn't have XLOOKUP, but it has everything else. Check out the book. Click that I in the top right-hand corner. I love this new XLOOKUP feature. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.